the 1920s, before Hollywood's heyday, entertaining was hard work, dangerous, sometimes desperate. The circus was king, and king of the circus was an Australian tightrope walker, Con Colleano.
Even though he's been forgotten in Australia, Con Colleano, internationally, is regarded as one of the greatest circus artists of all time.
Well, he was the best wire walker. There's no get away from that. Today, there's not too many wire walkers about today because it's a hell of a hard act. It's a mean act, you know. I suppose you could say he was there before people appreciated him, probably, in this country, but they appreciated him in America. They realised it there that he had the good.
This footage of Ringling Circus in the 20s was shot by Con Colleano. The salary of $1,000 US a week that the circus paid its star meant he had money to lavish on the latest gadgets.
At the height of its glory, Ringling Circus was a moving township comprised of about 1,600 people, required four trains to move it throughout the United States, carried, I think, about 800 animals of all descriptions, even had its own detectives, its own post office, its own bootleggers even. Most of the people, the circus artists and the employed people in the show, would have just had normal train accommodation, living in bunks. But Colleano and his wife Winnie, they were accorded the very special privilege of their own apartment on one of the Pullman carriages.
Merv King was given away to a circus by his grandmother when he was 7 years old. Con Colleano was in a rival troupe.
Very good looking fella, and quite a good boxer, and he knew he was pretty good, and he didn't put any punches about himself. He liked himself, but you didn't hold that against him because he was a likeable fella. I always went up into the dressing room to have a bit of a yap to him or something like that, and he was just getting ready, made up, ready to go on. He's looking in the glass, you know, and he said, "Boy, you're some good-looking fellow." I always remember that, just to himself sort of thing, you know.
The Wizard of the Wire was born Con Sullivan, one of 10 children of an Irish father and an Aboriginal mother. His father's boxing troupe evolved into a circus in which all 10 children performed, billed as Spaniards, Arabs, and even Royal Hawaiians.
He learned to be a Spaniard going overseas because this Spanish act taught him to speak a bit of Spanish. And for some reason or other, they were frightened of the Aboriginal wasn't that bright in the eyes of the public.
So I think the intention in adopting the name Colleano was to pass themselves off as some sort of exotic importation.
Ironically, this Spanish identity was to be the making of Con Colleano. His trademark cape dance was always the prelude to a matadorian wire act. When Rudolph Valentino died, Colleano was screen tested to replace the brooding Hollywood hero.
But when faced with the choice between becoming a screen star, a silent screen star, and keeping on as the highly paid star of Ringling Circus, he chose the latter.
So the circus was in his blood?
Oh yes, from birth.
You told me that it was his wife's idea, that it was Winnie's idea to make him into a Spaniard.
Well, that's only my, I think, because when he got married to Winnie, he improved out of sight in his presentation and that, and he became the way he moved and walked around on the stage, completely different.
While Colleano's wife Winnie may have taught him certain tricks, it was his somersaults on the wire which set him apart.
He lived, breathed, and ate almost the tightwire, I believe, throughout the world. There might be one or two who are doing it to various degrees, but even if they are, they have probably borrowed a lot of their art from Colleano.